Welcome back to Jersey Matters. The outgoing Obama administration tried to handcuff the incoming president by banning offshore oil and gas drilling along the coast of New Jersey and other mid-Atlantic states. Cindy Zipf is joining me now. She's the executive director of Clean Ocean Action, an ocean advocacy organization. We've had you on the show a couple
times.
Yes,
great to be here, Larry. Thank you
for coming back.
Thank you so
much. And we'll start with some news. Something happened recently that was our first discussion, our first talk about seismic testing.
Exactly. And it's very much tied to the other discussion that we'll be having is the Obama administration today denied all the outstanding permits for seismic testing. So that means the ocean will be quiet and not be blasted with these incredibly harmful sound waves that are used to pound through the miles of earth underwater to look for oil. So this is a very, very important victory.
Is this something that's potentially short-lived because the new president can just get rid of it?
Well, you know, that is true. The new president could come in and start the process again, but he would have to start the process again, which would, you know, take time. And again, so many people support the ocean. We're talking about a clean ocean economy and defending a clean ocean economy. And that's why President Obama did withdraw from the drilling in the Atlantic and the seismic testing, because millions of people support a clean ocean economy. And, you know, they persuaded the president to protect the Atlantic that so many depend upon.
But if you take the other side, they say to you, we're not doing anything bad to the Atlantic Ocean. We've come so far since the problems in the Gulf Coast, and we'd be minimally invasive.
Well, that's absolutely not true when it comes to oil drilling and exploration. I mean, first of all, you know, the seismic testing itself, you're blasting the eardrums of every living creature in the ocean. I mean, these sound pulses go for thousands of miles.
And just to explain to people, the seismic testing is just to find out if there's oil down there.
Right. That's the first stage, right, is to look, to explore and identify areas of where the oil is. And then it puts you on a path to the oil drilling. And, you know, that's where the additional harm occurs from the actual physical drilling activities, and, of course, if there is a spill. But all that industrial activity is polluting and harmful as well.
So will there be offshore oil drilling off of New Jersey? I think that's all anybody wants to know.
Right.
So you have the President Obama ban on this. You have Donald Trump saying he wants to do it. Where does that fight go?
Well, the fight is still with the people. And, you know, whether or not the administration does move forward and start a new process to go drill back in the Atlantic Ocean, we will be there to push and against it. Here on the Atlantic seaboard, so many businesses and industries depend on a healthy ocean. New Jersey alone, $32 billion is our tourism industry. That's a huge economic, you know, the idea that, you know, a few gallons of, even if it's a hundred, you know, a few days of oil or 100 days of oil off our coast, there is no equivalent to the economic interests that depend on that healthy ocean.
But the fact that you're here, the fact that we're talking about it, you do have a concern going forward
with
Donald Trump.
Absolutely.
Because of what he said so far.
His appointments and, you know, his you know, absolute clear
former
statements.
CEO of ExxonMobil is now the Secretary of State. It's going to have his ear.
Yes, and you know, the EPA will be headed by the great ocean state of Oklahoma. You know, so there is reason for concern. This is a very pro-fossil fuel administration coming in, and there's absolutely reason to be concerned. But there's also reason for hope that, you know, President Trump will look at the people and see that vast majority of people want a clean and healthy ocean. They don't want oil drilling in the Atlantic, and he will back off.
Is there an area that we're talking about specifically off of New Jersey that's being fought over?
He identified 31 canyon areas. These are areas that are very, very unique. These underwater canyon areas, there's where coral live. It's where, you know, there is some additional evidence of their sensitivity. So he utilized those. But it's only 3.8 million acres. That sounds like a lot. But when you consider the entire eastern seaboard, it's a small fraction. And, you know, there's...
But it's what he had the ability to protect.
Well, I feel that he would have had... He had the ability to, you know, expand the area. But I think he wanted to be more strategic and surgical about it by linking it to those canyon areas. And
that leaves a lot of ocean to drill in.
Huge. The entire shelf area. So basically from the coastline out to 100 or more miles is open.
So you will be there
throughout. We are there. Yes.
You we've are drawn there a now.
Line. We are there. We've drawn the line in the sand many, many years ago. Every governor for the last 30 years in New Jersey has opposed offshore oil and gas drilling, whether a Republican or Democrat. This is a nonpartisan issue. And that's really important. And New Jersey's delegation has been fantastic on this issue in a bipartisan way, saying, no way. We know what the Jersey Shore, how important it is. And they've also led many other elected officials throughout the coastal states to join that fight and to see the value of the ocean.
As the fight intensifies, and it may not, because we don't really know what Donald Trump's going to do. Just because he said one thing doesn't mean he's going to follow
True
through
enough.
With that. But if the fight does intensify, you'll come back and
Absolutely.
Tell us how it's going.
Yeah.
All right, Cindy Zipf, thank you very much.
Thank you.
She is the executive director of Clean Ocean Action, which is an ocean advocacy organization. That's Jersey Matters for this week. You know, you can go to our website to replay this segment or any segment from this show or previous shows and leave your comments about what you've seen today on our Facebook page or reach out to me on Twitter. We may read your thoughts on a future show. I'm Larry Menti. See you again next week.